So here we have a triangle ABC, which is an isosceles triangle with AB equal to AC. BE is the altitude on the side AC. CF is the altitude on the side AB. Given this, we need to prove that the altitudes BE and CF are equal. So in other words, in an isosceles triangle, the altitudes on the equal sides are also equal. This is the statement we have to prove. I repeat the statement. In an isosceles triangle, the altitudes on the equal sides are also equal. That is what we have to prove. Let's see the proof here. We can prove this result in two different ways. We'll see the first method here. BE is a side of triangle ABE. CF is a side of the triangle ACF. So let's take up these two triangles and prove that they are congruent to each other. Angle 1 of the first triangle is equal to angle 1 of the second triangle, meaning angle 1 is an angle common to both the triangles. Angle 2 of the first triangle equals angle 3 of the second triangle, each angle equal to 90 degrees. AB of this triangle is equal to AC of this triangle. AB equal to AC is given to us in the question because ABC is an isosceles triangle. So we have listed two pairs of equal angles and one pair of equal sides. Angle 1 and angle 2 contain the side AE. So clearly AB is not the included side. Angle 1 and angle 3 contain the side AF. Angle 1 and angle 3 contain the side AF. So clearly AC is not the included side. So by the AAS congruence criterion, the two triangles are congruent to each other. So see it here. Triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACF by the AAS congruence criterion. So now that the triangles are congruent, their corresponding sides are equal. So we have BE equal to CF, CPCTC. See the other method here. BE, we need to prove that BE equals CF. BE is a side of this triangle. CF is a side of this triangle. So let's take up these two triangles and show that they are congruent to each other. Angle 4 of triangle BFC is equal to angle 5 of triangle CEB. Again, because each of these angles equals 90 degrees. Now we know that AB is equal to AC. So the angle opposite to AB will be equal to the angle opposite to AC. Which is the angle opposite to AB? This is the side AB. This is the angle opposite to AB, which is angle ACB, which can also be called angle ECB. Because we have taken up this triangle, so let's call it ECB. And this is the side AC. The angle opposite to AC is angle ABC. This is the side AC. Opposite to the side AC is angle ABC, which can also be called angle FBC. Because we have taken up this triangle, so let's call it angle FBC. This angle, FBC. So, since in triangle ABC, AB equals AC, the angle opposite to AB is equal to the angle opposite to AC. So we have angle FBC equal to angle ECB. And BC is a side common to both the triangles. Both the triangles stand on the same base BC. So we have BC equals BC common side. So what have we listed? We have again listed two pairs of equal angles and one pair of equal sides. Again, BC is not the side, it's not the side contained by these angles. Let's check that. See here, angle 4 and this angle FBC, correct? Angle 4 and angle FBC of this triangle contain the side FB. See here, this is the angle FBC and this is angle 4. These two angles contain the side FB. So BC is not the included side. Again, in the other triangle, we have mentioned about angle 5 and angle ECB. And these two angles contain the side EC and not BC. So clearly, BC is not the side contained by these angles. So by the AAS, two angles and some other side, by the AAS congruence criterion, the two triangles are congruent to each other. So now that the triangles are congruent, their corresponding sides are equal, their corresponding angles are equal, what do we need to show? We need to show that BE equals CF. So see here, BE or EB, you can see it here, EB equals FC. FC, EB. First and third vertex, first and third vertex. FB, EB. Alright, so we have CF, you can also call it CF. CF equals BE, CPCTC.